This video is about our testing possibilities at Mondi. First, our research and development center, where we objectively compare and assess the quality of different paper. Let's take a look at how the most important measurements are carried out. First step, the preparation of the samples. The exact cutting of the samples and the continuous control and monitoring of the test climate are crucial for the repeatability and comparability, as the test results must meet international standards. In addition, the testing equipment is regularly monitored by external testing institutes, like this device, which we use to measure the strength properties of the sample. A 15mm wide test strip is clamped and then pulled apart. The tensile strength is determined. This indicates the maximum tensile force at which the paper tears. Also important is the elongation, how much the sample stretches before it tears. Both values result in the essential value, tensile energy absorption. This value indicates how much drop energy the paper can withstand before it tears. The deaeration of the sac is another essential criterion to be considered. The air resistance, measured in Gurley seconds, is the decisive value here. It indicates how many seconds it takes to force 100 milliliters of air through the paper at a defined pressure. A low value means high air permeability, which enables good deaeration and shorter filling times. Once we have all the important information about the paper, we move on to our bag application center. Here, we have all the facilities to carry out standardized tests for different functionalities of the sac construction. First step is the Big Gurley test, where we measure the air permeability of the sac wall. In this test, a chamber that is open at the top is sealed with a sample from the sac wall. After opening the air supply, we measure how many cubic meters of air can flow through the sac wall per hour, while maintaining a constant pressure of 50 millibars in the chamber below the sample. The big brother of this is the Mega Gurley test. With the Mega Gurley, we measure the airflow through the entire sac, not just through a paper sample. A constant pressure of 50 millibars is regulated in the sac using the air supply to simulate a filling situation. Then we measure how many cubic meters of air escape per hour at a constant pressure of 50 millibars. In addition to sac deaeration, many other factors, such as the fineness of the filling material, influence the filling process. For this purpose, we can measure the internal pressure that builds up in the sac during filling. These different filling curves then show us which sac design delivers the best filling performance. After a sac has been filled, it often happens in the supply chain that the sac is subjected to a drop strain during loading, reloading, or handling. To simulate this type of load, known as dynamic loading, the drop test is used. In this test, a filled sac is dropped either always from the same drop height or from a drop height that increases with each drop until the sac tears. A high-speed camera can then be used to evaluate the breakage characteristics or detect weak points in the sac design. Last but not least, our climate chamber, in which the sacs can embark on a trip around the world. Six climate zones can be created in terms of temperature and humidity. This allows us to find out how well different sac designs protect their contents in different climates. Each sac should prove itself on the filling lines and protect its contents from all kinds of influences in the best possible way. That is why we offer all our customers both the test equipment in our Research and Development Innovation Center and the tests in BAC, the Bag Application Center, to help them optimize their packing solutions. For further information, please get in touch with us or visit our Mondi Go to Sac app.